Health experts in Barara City are advising people with serious illnesses, including diabetes, high blood pressure, and other non-communicable diseases, to stay in their homes until the country is declared safe from the COVID-19 second wave. The call was made by Dr. Justice Ampire, a medical doctor at St. Augustine's Medical Center, who was concerned that such category of people fall into the extremely vulnerable group that would present with severe conditions if exposed to COVID-19.
High-risk patients in Barara City have been advised to stay in their homes. Giving COVID-19 prevention health tips, Dr. Ampire also said people with asthma, those having treatment of cancer, those who have undergone organ transplantation, and others with respiratory conditions should adhere to health advice. He advised such people to always go for COVID-19 testing in case they get any sign. He urged those employed but have underlying health conditions to ask for permission and work from home to avoid exposure.
So now, first of all, we need to prevent ourselves from acquiring the COVID, especially all of us, but when you have an underlying condition. If you know you're diabetic, if you know you have a lot of, you have asthma, you get attacks, if you know your CD4 cell count is low, you have HIV, we will require you, at least for you, I don't know if you're working, you might have to ask for an extra permission to stay home, to be away from people who can infect you with COVID. Because when it catches you, then you are at a very high risk of ending up in ICU. You are at a very high risk or even not making it.
With lifestyle diseases like hypertension, diabetes, Dr. Ampire encouraged people to invest much of their time in doing exercises and eating well. He also cautioned smokers that they are putting their lives at risk in this period of COVID-19.
Find time to do some exercises. You can do them in your compound with your children. Do some exercises. Eat healthy. Don't have a lot of carbohydrates, a lot of fat, a lot all the time. Put in vegetables, have a lot of fruits, you know. Now you have time to look for the vegetables, please look for them. If you don't have, try to grow in the backyard so that at least our lifestyle is improved.
The first case of COVID-19 was confirmed in Uganda in March 2020, and by close of today, the disease has claimed lives of 600 people, with over 3.8 million dead across the globe. Meanwhile, six health workers in Fort Poto have tested positive for the COVID-19. One of the infected health workers has passed on, while the others are receiving treatment at the same health facility, according to Dr. David Mwirwombi, the COVID-19 case management team leader at the Fort Poto Regional Referral Hospital.
Apparently, we are only admitting those who are critically ill. The number of cases are in home-based care, and we have health workers who are following them up. We've had about six staff who got infected. We lost one, but the rest are maybe fine.
Cumulatively, Fort Poto Regional Referral Hospital has since the break of the COVID-19 handled a total of 211 patients. According to Dr. Mwirwombi, most of the COVID-19 cases being referred to the facility are from Kasese District. To minimize on congestion at the facility, the hospital has introduced visitors' cards for all patient attendants, which card admits only one person.
Caretakers' cards. We would only allow one caretaker and would give them a card which allows them in. Yeah, but apparently the situation, since the situation has escalated, we have also seen the number of patients also reducing on those other wards.
The Fort Poto Regional Referral Hospital is currently admitting only critically ill patients, while others are being managed under home-based care. The hospital has increased its capacity to handle COVID-19 patients, and according to Dr. Mwirwombi, they currently have a bed capacity of over 100 patients. On oxygen supply, Dr. Mwirwombi disclosed that the hospital produces its own oxygen, which it also supplies to other health facilities.
In CTU, we use use about 40 cylinders. Yeah. But that plant supplies the whole region, and then it also supplies the other wards. So if I'm to estimate correctly, maybe about 70 cylinders per day.
This story was compiled by Abdul Karim Sengendo and Rogers Sandy for the news in Fort Portal.